What is up, guys? This is Nether3JK here, and today I will show you guys how to set up a bungee cord server. Now, you guys may be wondering, what is bungee cord? Bungee cord is basically a replacement for like Craft Bucket, which requires its own server to run on, and it links servers together, basically. So, before I get started, I do want to say that this tutorial was made possible by Exodus Hosting. They set me up 3 servers to set it up on. So first we got our bungee cord server. We're gonna work on this one first. So we're gonna go and download the latest bungee cord successful build. And while that's downloading, I do want to say that we also have a 10% off discount code for Exodus, which is really good, especially with their already really low prices. So, now we want to let that finish downloading. And I'm going to go ahead and launch my FileZilla client. You will need FileZilla to upload bungee cord if you are using Exodus, because it's larger than the limit. So, I'm going to go ahead and connect to the FTP over here. Just copy down all this information. And the file is ready. So I'm going to show in folder, and I'm going to drag it onto my desktop. Rename it to just bungee cord. And, 1 second. I already have a bungee cord here. I'm going to delete it. That was from earlier. So yeah, I'm going to rename it now to just bungee cord. And I'm going to upload it into the jars folder. And I'm going to go back now. And as soon as it's uploaded, I'm going to start the server. But one thing I do want to say is this bungee cord stuff, it does not require your server to be running Bucket or some kind of special stuff. For this tutorial, I have one running the default Minecraft server, and then I have the other one running the beta build of Craft Bucket, or development build of Craft Bucket 1.5.2. But although I think the default one is outdated, so we're gonna go back over to the bungee cord now, and you're gonna want to make sure that you're the jar file name is, you want to change that to bungeecord.jar so it runs this particular file. And then you want to save it and start your server. And to show that it's working, I'm going to go into console, and it says listening on, and then a whole bunch of numbers, which represents the server. So now you just want to start, you want to stop the bungee cord. So I spam click because I'm impatient, and you're going to want to copy down the IP address of your server. We will need this for the next part of the tutorial setup, or setup tutorial. So now I got it copied, boom, copied. We're going to go down to the FTP file access area, login, and you're going to look for config.yml. Okay, so I'm going to go through this configuration top to bottom, one by one. If there's anything I skip over, make a comment in the comment sections below, and I would love to answer your questions about it. Okay, before I start here, I want to say that the default server, like the server that people connect to first, I'm going to leave that as lobby. But you can change it to hub or anything else. But I'm going to leave it to lobby for the sake of using this. So the fallback server, basically when the server crashes, it will send them back to the lobby. The max players, this is the number of players that it says before you join the game, although that is not actually like the legitimate max players. You can set the legitimate max players on the bottom, which is like the total max of players allowed within the network at the time. And then for the host, you see the 0.0.0.0 port 25577. You want to change that to the IP address of your server that you copied down a moment ago. Tab size, I would leave that as 60, but you can change it to like 100, like some servers are. And force default server. I set this to true because when players join the network, it forces them to go back to the lobby before venturing off elsewhere in the network. This helps players see what else your network has to offer, and yeah, I'll set it to true. Texture pack size, not going to discuss that. MOTD, I'm going to change it to Exodus Bungie. Default server is going to stay lobby. Forest host, don't care about that, ignore that. And then we have servers. So I have the two servers set up that are actually going to be playable. So I'm going to go ahead and jot down the IP address of one of them. And I'm going to make this the lobby server. So Bungie Code 1, lobby. And I'm also going to change this to Craft Bucket. And restart it. Alright, so right here where it says localhost port 25565, the address is going to be changed to the IP address of the lobby server. Just like that. And, that is set up now. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to copy this whole section right here and paste it a line below. But for the other server, we are going to call it Survival. We're going to call it Survival, and we're going to go grab the IP address of our other server. So I'm going to go ahead and save that. Jot down the IP address. And I am going to put it right there. Where the address slot is for the Survival server. Status, do not mess with that. That is automatically generated. And global ping, I would leave it at global ping. That's basically when you hit tab. If you see people for just the server you're on or the entire network, I would leave it to global because I don't know the other ping thing. Max players, we're going to set that to 100. No, I'm going to set it to 150. Nah, I'm kidding. I'm just going to leave it negative 1. Infinite. Online mode, true, because we want a premium network. And timeout, I'm going to leave that default. Then we have groups. MD underscore 5, that is the creator of this. And I'm going to replace his name with my name. And I will be marked as an admin. So, I'm going to go ahead and save this. Go back. And I am going to go ahead and launch my client. And I am also going to go start the Bungie Code server. So now it should say listening on your server's IP and then the port. Because I did not get the default port, I'm gonna have to connect still using the IP and the port instead of just the numbers without the port. If that made any sense. Let me log in. Let me update Minecraft on this computer. And when I go in game, I'll also show you more in-depth commands with this. And for all the servers I have on here, they are running absolutely no plugins. If you would like a tutorial on like how to set up like a server-to-server portal system, if I get it by request in the comment section below, I would love to make one. So now, we stare at the Mojang screen. Alright, so, the lobby and the Survival server are online, and so is the Bungie. Although the Bungie is pinging as offline, it is online. It's not supposed to be read as a Minecraft server, because it doesn't give the response as a normal Minecraft server does back to console. And, like, this needs to hurry up. And it went there for a second. One second. So irritating. But as you can see, get out of here. After the Survival Server, everything down here, this is actually the Zethon Network setup. After the bungee cord setup to Survival Server. And the Zethon bungee is right here. You can see a lot of messages in here. And yeah. So now I'm going to go ahead and connect to the server after I go into the bungee console. I paste the IP address, and I'm now joining. Failed to verify username. Ooh, 1 second. Oh yeah, I remember what I did now. Okay, scratch that, we're not ready yet. For all your servers, you have to change all your servers to online mode equals false. So you have to basically make all your other servers crack. Otherwise, what you just saw will happen to you. So I want to make them cracked and restart them. I'm sorry if I'm doing this really fast. Eager to get in game. So if you're buying servers from Exodus for this, I would only buy the bungee cord server, like the server you're going to use for the actual bungee. I would run that one as a default port. That's the only one I would run as a default port. The rest I would leave as a random port. Alright, so pasting IP address and logging in. So let me make sure my settings are correct. Okay, this is good. So, this is not actually going to be, like, a gameplay stuff, so lag should not really matter. It's just going to be a whole bunch of commands. So, as you can see, I am on the lobby, which is right here. I am technically on the server now. And you may be wondering, what am I going to do now? You can type /server. And you'll see all the servers that you can connect to, which right now it's Lobby and Survival. And another thing you can do is type /glist, and you can see the statistics for all the servers within the network. Like Lobby is 1, and for Net3JK. Total on players online, 1. And you can also type /alert, and I'm going to add some colors into this message. Hey. This is a test. Okay, really funky. That's not even a test. But as you can see, it says alert. Hey, this is a teat. spelling error on my behalf there. But that would basically be broadcasted throughout the whole network for everyone connecting to your servers using the bungee cord. This is when portals would come into play, but I'm not going to go through the whole portal process unless you guys want me to. But I will do it if you guys demand it in the comments. So I'm going to run. No. Oh, I saw a creeper. No, give me away. No. Told you this isn't supposed to be gameplay. Alright, so we're going to try to connect to the lobby server. And it says you cannot connect to the server you're already on. So we are on the lobby. So now we're going to go switch over to the survival. And keep in mind, /server and such is all case sensitive. So as you can see, I left the lobby server, according to the statistics, and I am now over in the survival server. So, that is basically how you set up and configure bungee cord using Exodus hosting, along with just about any other server host. And exit Bungie, that's the MOTD reset with the 100 slots. So, if you found this video helpful, hit the like button. If I was unclear at some parts, just go ahead and comment down in the comment section below, and I will see what I could do in assisting you with your setup. Exodus, pretty cheap Minecraft server hosting, but yet good quality, with a 10% discount code, which will be in the description. So, in the description, I will have a link to the Bungie Core download, the Exodus hosting link as my affiliate's link, my referral link, essentially, and then the 10% off discount code. Thanks for watching, and if you found this helpful, please like, comment, rate, and subscribe. This is NethierJK, and peace.